السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. I am Dr. Muhammad for teaching Arabic language, inshallah. Then I will be with you for teach you all of the magic about the Arabic language. But important for you before I start, get your notebook and pen to carry write everything down with you, inshallah. Okay. So, most of the people they are asking me before, how could we learn this language? Arabic language, one of the most famous language, we should learn it in any place. We should make the conversation, or we are using this conversation in you know, like in most of the Arabic country, like Dubai, Bahrain, Kuwait, Egypt. We are using all of that conversation. So I will try to help you for some words which will help you to make a conversation if you are visitor in one of the Arab country, or you will go to make a trade with this country, or you will go to work in one of the Arabian country. I will help you for every place, inshallah, which it have most of the Arabic language. Okay. In the beginning, the question which is most of the people they asked me, oh, Dr. Muhammad, like the Arabic language is so hard. It's so complicated. It's even like the pronunciation is hard. No, it's not about the pronunciation is hard or something like that. Is same like any language. If you speak it well, you can able to make a good conversation with anyone Arabian, or with anyone understand the Arabic language. So in the beginning, you cannot learn how to understand the Arabic. This is the most important thing for the Arabic language. You cannot understand the Arabic, or you cannot understand any language before you able to read and write this language. But I will shorten this way with you to can I learn you some of the few words you will go into use it in your daily life as a routine. Once you are use it more and more, much and much with using all of that words, you will go into pronounce it correctly, and you will go into say it easily. Same like, please bring to me the notebook, please. Please, I need a pen, or like I need any something like that. So it will be easy for you to can you listen it to this word very correctly, very easy, and you will go into repeat it again and again. Okay, so I will go into give you some few words. And word beside word, you will go on to make a sentence you will go on to use with any of the Arabic composition. Okay, if I shorten this way, and if you get your notebook, then as well. So in the beginning, we will go on to study the classroom. Okay, some of the classroom, as you know, like the study will go on to be start. So, and I hate the school. When I was young, I was like, this was like, you know, the hard day for me, like the school. But after that, I didn't notify that it was like that, but it is easy. So I'm for here, like I'm here for you to can I make all this language so easy for you, and you will go to visit us here in Egypt, and we will see you again and again. Okay, so let me start first. Like the, you know, we will go into take the most important stuff, which is about Hujratul Dirasa. Hujratul Dirasa is meaning classroom. Classroom. I will pronounce it easily, and you will go into pronounce it with me as well. Hujratul Dirasa. Hujratu. Hujratu. Hujratu is meaning room. And you can use this word for any room in the flat, or any room in your house. Like حجرة الملابس like the clothes room or حجرة النوم sleeping room. Okay, so any room in the Arabic language, it's called حجرة. Again, it's called حجرة. Repeat it with me. حجرة. الدراسة. الدراسة. الدراسة is meaning studying, which is meaning class, and it has like a lot of meaning, like classroom or like studying. الدراسة come from the verb called يدرسو. يدرسو. الدراسة is the noun, which it has alif and lam in the beginning, this one. So if we have it like in any noun, we will go into habits, then it will be so easy to can you make it easy and good for you. الدراسة. So حجرة الدراسة, it means classroom. Repeat it again. حجرة الدراسة. Again, حجرة الدراسة. Okay. In حجرة الدراسة, there is a lot of tools we are using in the classroom. Okay. Again, notebook and pen. Okay, so in the first word we will go on to study it today, which is called كراسة. Repeat after me. كراسة. What does it mean, كراسة? Here, good. It's notebook. Very good. So repeat it after me again. كراسة. And I wrote it to you. The good one who is right all of that word in the notebook, because I am the next class, I will go on to ask. The good one, he will go on to take that course once he comment to me on that video. So say it again. كراسة. Again. كراسة. Okay. Second word, we will go on to take it, which is called كتاب. Again, كتاب. What does it mean, كتاب? Book. Very good. So we have notebook, كراسة, and we have the big one, which is called كتاب. Repeat it after me again. كتاب. كتاب. Okay. So the next one, we will go into use it, such a word we use it million time in our day. Wa, only. What does it wa mean? Huh? The one who is comment correctly, write to me the comment to can you get this course. Wa, it means and. And so if I say, me and my friend Muhammad where Samir. Muhammad where Samir. What does it mean, where? Where it means? And. Very good. And. So if I need to say and for anything for the Arabic language, I use WA. Where. Where. So what does that mean? قلم. قلم. Okay, very good. So I have now two words, which is called كراسة, notebook, and كتاب is the big book. Okay, كتاب. Second two words we will go to learn today. قلم. قلم. This one, it's called قلم. قلم. The people who say are not Arabs, they said كلم. كلم. No, it's not correct. We should pronounce it the letter قاف. This one, letter قاف, correct. So ق, قلم, come from your throat. قلم. ق. ق. Not ك. I teach you well. Okay. Don't forget that. I'm not will teach you the not good pronunciation. No, I will teach you the correct pronunciation for each letter in that course. try to pronounce it. قلم. Say it again. قلم. Pen. قلم. Okay, very good. So the second word, we will go into use it. مسطرة. Again. مسطرة. Repeat it again. مسطرة. It's meaning ruler. Ruler. Be careful about the teacher who they have like a mispronunciation about ra, because the ruler is find out all of these people. Ruler. Say it. Ruler. So it's called مسطرة. So if I have a pen and ruler, how could I say it? قلم. Good. Where. And don't forget and. Where. مسطرة. قلم ومسطرة. If you pronounce it here, you will go on to find it. Write it down, I said. قلم ومسطرة. Say it again. So now, like in the classroom, I learn four new words. كراسة. Notebook. Where. And. كتاب. كتاب. Book. Where. And. قلم. قلم. Where. مسطرة. Ruler. My practice for you, for the Arabic language at all, be careful when you use such as this word, try to use it in the Arabic way to can your tongue such as pronounce it and repeat it much more and more and more, you will going to be practice it very well. So in the classroom, when you back to school, try to use it. I need my pen. Instead of I say pen, I need my قلم. Very good. I know I should teach you how to say all of that sentence, but I'm starting this course from the beginning, like just a few words, so can you use it in your routine? Okay. Like, please, can you bring to me the book? Can you bring to me the كتاب. Can you bring it to me? The كتاب. So what does it mean? كتاب. Book. Very good. What does it mean? كراسة. Notebook. Very good. Where it means? And. MashaAllah. It is very good. MashaAllah. So in that we teach or we studied four words. كراسة. وكتاب وقلم ومسطرة. So if I need to say my name and my brother, okay, so I will go on to say محمد وأحمد. و it means and. The one who will go on to answer such as the questions that I will go on to say it now will go on to move to this course in the next. What does it mean? And notebook and ruler. Three. Answer me in the comment. Thank you.